The indirect function allows you to point Excel to a particular cell based on the contents of another cell, and you can even specify which sheet should be used in a formula. Easiest way to explain it is just to give you an example. So what I've got here is a couple of lookup references and some data scattered all over the place. I'm going to create a formula here. So if I did this, if I said equals to that cell, you'll see it brings through whatever's in that cell, B6. However, the indirect formula has the effect, so I'm going to go to the function wizard and find the indirect formula. If I point here, what it is basically doing is telling Excel, go look in the cell, whatever you find in there, that's where you must actually go look. So can you see it says B6? What it's going to do is go look in this cell. So when I say OK, can you see it brings back 1.333 to this cell over here. Just doing that again, I'm going to use the indirect function. I'm going to say please look in that cell there. And what you'll see is it brings back 45. Why? Because it goes there, looks in the cell, says I need to go to D7. Finds D7, gives me the answer here. If, for example, I change this to B6, like the one above, the answer now looks there. Just change that back. It even works for name ranges. So if you look at this cell here, it's no longer called E8, it's called units. I've typed the word units in here. What I can do is go in here, find my indirect, and I'm going to say, look at that cell. It knows to look for something called units, and when I click OK, can you see it brings through a 10? It's looking over here. You can even use other ways to actually create the address. So in this case, this cell here has got a 9 in it, because what I want to do is to use C and whatever numbers in there. So the column I'm going to give, but the row will come from the cell. Again, we're going to use the indirect. And the reference, I'm actually going to, in inverted commas, type the C. I'm going to put the ampersand. I'm going to point at that cell. So what you can see is Excel is seeing C9. So it's going to go find what number's in there. It knows it's now C9. Goes to C9 and brings through that answer. So I'm going to say OK, and you can see it brings through the 62. Now let's show you how you can go across different sheets. So for the first part over here, I'm just going to go look for whatever's in K20. So we're going to do our normal indirect and point there. And when I say OK, you'll see it's gone to K20. Which is over here, and you'll see it's got a little sentence in it. This is looking within the sheet. Now we want to look for that cell, but not in this sheet, but in another sheet. You can build the address up manually by putting all the correct letters and words in, but we like to use the address function. If we go to the address function, you'll see it allows you to build up the address step by step. So row number, you can ask for row 20. Column is column K, which is the 11th column. You can already see it's made part of the address. You can decide whether you want it to be absolute or not. Doesn't really matter in this case. And whether you want to use A1 or R1 C1 style, doesn't matter again. And for the sheet text, if you want, you can just write it out. Just don't forget in your inverted commas. And what you'll see is it takes the combination of this and creates an address. And for now, I'm just going to say OK. And now over here, I can use the indirect function and just point it here. When I say OK, you'll see that what it's saying is the same as what's over here. So you can basically use the indirect function to go to any sheet here.